Oasis Audio presents The Five Love Languages by Dr. Gary Chapman, read for you by Dr. Chapman. For Oasis Audio, I'm Wayne Shepherd, talking with Dr. Gary Chapman, the author of The Five Love Languages, a revised edition, Gary?
Yes, after all these years, we've done a little tweaking on the text.
So how much different is this new edition?
Well, it's not radically different. I didn't change the five love languages.
You didn't add five more?
But we do have more contemporary examples of couples learning to speak these languages.
Yeah. For those who are picking this up for the first time, take me all the way back to the beginning, which was what? Nearly 20 years ago now.
Yeah, it first came out in 1992.
Did it? Okay.
And I remember the publisher said to me when it first came out, you know, this is a nice little book. I think it'll sell a few thousand copies.
Did you have trouble getting a publisher?
No, not really, because I had already published two books, and so it was no trouble getting it published. But I think all of us underestimated what would happen to this book.
Mm-hmm. Tell me the story. What has happened to this
book? Well, you know, it's been out now for 15, 16 years, and every year it has sold more than the year before. Total sales in English now is over 5 million copies, been translated in 38 languages around the world. So it has really just blown our minds to sit back and watch, you know, how this book has been used to help so many couples learn how to reconnect with each other.
For those who don't know the story, where did this come from in your own heart and mind, Gary?
Well, it came out of my counseling experience. You know, I've been in marriage counseling for over 35 years now, just working with hundreds and hundreds of couples. And I realized that after a while that I was hearing the same stories over and over again. They would sit in my office and one of them would say, I just feel like he doesn't love me. And the other one would say, I don't know. I don't know what they want. You know, I do this and this and this, and they don't feel loved. I don't understand this. And so I would try to help them understand what made her feel loved, what made him feel loved, so that they could start, you know, expressing love that way. So I went through my notes after probably 12 years of notes and asked myself, what are people crying for? You know, when they say I don't feel loved, what do they want? And their answers fell into five categories. I wasn't looking for five. It's just they fell into five categories. And it was later then I called them the five love languages. But I started using the concept in my counseling and in small groups. And every time I did, people got it, you know, and they said, oh, yeah. And so after a while, I thought, you know, if I could put this in a book and if I could write it in the language of the common man, I could help a lot of people. There's not a lot of psychological terms in this book or, you know, theological terms. It's just I'm trying to write so the average guy and gal can get it.
It's simple. It's straightforward. It's easy to understand.
Yeah.
Isn't it amazing how God has used that?
Well, it is. You know, and a lot of people have said to me, you know, I read that and I thought, why didn't I think of that? You know, I mean, it seems so simple, and it is simple. Now, it's not always easy to implement.
Right.
Because many of us grew up speaking only one or two of these languages. That's all we heard in our family. So if you talk about physical touch, and I was not touched, I was not in a touchy-feely family, that's hard for me to learn to touch. And the same thing is true with words of affirmation. If you didn't get words of affirmation, it doesn't seem natural to you to be saying these things, you know, to your spouse. So it's not easy for everybody, but it is simple to get the concept. And the good news is you can learn to speak these things. And when you do, it makes a tremendous difference in your marriage.
You must have collected stories through the years of people whose marriages have literally been saved because of the five love languages. Can you tell me a couple of those stories? I even have one of my own. I talked recently with a cousin of mine who's in his 40s. He and his wife are separated. They're still separated, but he is devouring your book. He came to me with it. He said, hey, have you ever heard of this book, The Five Love Languages? See, this is great stuff. I'm going to win my wife back with this.
You know, Wayne, every week when I do marriage seminars, I do about 30 seminars a year all over the country. They're Saturday events. Every Saturday, I have half a dozen people come by and say to me things like, you know, we were that close to divorce. Somebody gave us your book. We read it. It made sense. We tried it. It turned our marriage around.
What have you got to lose, right?
Absolutely. You know, and so, yes, and the book is just filled with these kind of stories, you know, of course. But every week I hear that. And to me, it's so encouraging because it says to me that the book is continuing to speak to people. People are still discovering this book. You know, after 16 years, they're just now discovering it. And that's new to them. And when you do discover it and apply it in your marriage, it makes a tremendous difference in your marriage.
Gary, tell me more what goes on inside you when you hear people come to you and say, God has used your book this way in my life. But for both you and your wife, because this has been a team project, hasn't it?
Well, it has been. And, you know.
Sample complete. Ready to continue?